Hey everybody, welcome back. This is Carlos Cavallo from datingadviceguru.com, those dating relationship tips you love. Today, a hot topic, again, I know, I keep coming up with them. We're gonna talk about dating men over 40. That's right, five tips you must know. Now, if you've been around long enough, you know that things change when you get a little older, especially when it comes to love and relationships. Dating isn't just a giggly little trip to the movies like it used to be when you were a teenager or maybe in your 20s. But the good news is that things are actually better later on. You're wiser, you're more confident, you don't have time to waste on game playing with those other players out there. And if you have to date a guy over 40, you should know how to handle yourself and not get surprised in the process. First, a little quick reminder about the benefits of dating older guys. Older guys are better in bed, usually anyway, and that's good for both of you. Older guys are more established in their career, so they have more time for you. Older guys have more interests and hobbies to include you in on. It's not just about playing beer pong on the weekends anymore. And older guys are usually in a better place financially. If you find yourself dating a guy who's still struggling at over the age of 40 with his money, well, that's a red flag. As a matter of fact, let's start out with tip number one. Dating a guy over 40, tip one is follow the money. Watch how a guy treats you and how he treats his money. It goes without saying that if you're dating a guy, you want a guy that treats you right, but you also want to choose a guy that has his financial, you know what, together. Let's be realistic. If you're a woman dating a guy, you do care about how much he makes. Nothing says unattractive more than a low ambition guy who's content to just scrape by on a minimum wage job. And frankly, if you're still dating these guys, you need to level up, honey. I know you're saying, what, Carlos? Are you saying it's okay to be a gold digger? Well, no, I'm not saying you should be looking for some sugar daddy to support you for the rest of your life. However, if you want a relationship with a real man, you need to choose a guy that's earning his keep. You see, women are attracted to rich men for a very practical reason. His earnings generally show how ambitious a provider he is. Women are attracted to providers, and men are happy to provide for you. So don't feel guilty that you're turning into one of those women. Looking at his earnings potential is just another way of seeing if you're going to be stuck with some Homer Simpson or a guy that's going to lift you up and take you a little higher in life. Courtship after age 40, tip number two, don't turn on the change machine. A guy in his 40s is not going to be clay, my dear. He's going to actually be pretty well set in his ways by now, meaning that you're not likely to change him. And the worst thing you can possibly do is to turn on your change machine and make him into your little fixer-upper. I might argue that trying to change any man is a bad idea, especially because it sends the message that he's not good enough as he is. And this is the same thing as rejection to a man. I'd also suggest that trying to change him is even more of a waste of time on a guy in his 40s or later. When a guy's reached his 40s, their personality is pretty well set in stone. He knows who he is and what he wants and doesn't want. The key for you is to choose a guy that's perfect enough and leave it at that. Show gratitude for what you have. All right, dating a silver fox, tip number three is remember what he wants. If you want to hook a guy who's in his 40s and is a better prospect for a partner, you got to know what he's looking for in a woman. In a study of over 650,000, yeah, that's thousands, of online dating profiles, the top two traits that men want in a woman in order are, in their 30s, it's fun and honest. In their 40s, fun and honest. And guess what? In his 50s, it's fun and honest. Yes, those are the top two traits of guys of pretty much any age. Now, there's a bunch of other important stuff he's looking for that he won't tell you about. I tell you about that in my programs, but you'd be surprised how few women actually try to be fun in a relationship. And you might wonder, Carlos, what do men consider fun in a woman? First off, she's more focused on doing things with her man than she is worrying about wondering where the relationship is going. She's more focused on playfulness than defending herself or arguing about things that just hurt her feelings. She's also quick to get past her inner drama. She embraces the next laugh with a man instead of worrying about whether she can get him to commit to her. Oh, and another trait that's essential to a guy is up next. Dating a mature guy, tip number four, be a dog. Wait, that doesn't sound quite right, but it's true. You know those little furry pets that stick by your side through thick or thin, renowned for their loyalty? Yeah, dogs. If there's one trait that a man values but probably would never tell you directly, it's loyalty. Men are very aware of the relative loyalty level of the women that they date. It's kind of like we have this little meter going off in our brains that registers every word and action of yours. We look at what you say about your friends, how loyal you are with them. We watch how you react to us and our occasional missteps and foibles. We look at the patterns of your life. Do you tend to move from job to job? Do you shift your alliances and loyalties with your family and friends? Do you tend to talk crap about somebody behind their back, but then act hypocritical later on? That stuff is all going to go into the loyal registry file of your guy's head. I can't emphasize this trait enough. And if you show him your loyalty, you'll earn his 1,000 times over. Which brings us to dating men over 40, tip number 5, show him commitment. This tip is going to blow your mind, mushroom cloud style. Men want commitment. Yes, all men do, but especially men over 40. See, we're looking at the second half of our life, and we want somebody to spend it with, to share laughs and adventures with. And at this age, we've also been able to establish ourselves more in our careers. A guy in his 40s is also starting to feel a little insecure about his marital status, especially if he's not married like his friends. Being single will take a toll on a man's ego. If he's over 40 and he's past his first marriage, he probably knows what it is he wants. He's ripe for the picking. You see, for all women's complaining about getting a man to commit, there's a few things you need to know. Number one, a lot of women are commitment phobic. Yeah, it's true. I get letters every day from women that realize they're actually pushing men away with their overly critical and overly specific lists of what they want in a man. Men are also rarely commitment phobic. Yeah, this one will be super hard to swallow, but it's also true. And here's why. When a man acts scared of commitment, what he's really doing is telling you that he needs, well, he's seeing some behaviors that make him worry about long-term feelings of attraction for you. Now, the truth is the commitment is not hard to get from a man if you know how he thinks. Okay, you need to understand how he might be careful about who he is, who he lets into his heart. Now, maybe you've tried everything. You've tried ignoring your suspicions, being honest or speaking and showing your feelings. You've tried playing hard to get. You've tried everything to make it work with him. You follow all the advice out there, but he doesn't seem to respond. Now, if you've tried everything, you should know that there is a very simple way to get into a man's heart. When you know what a man is looking for to commit to a woman, you'll have a roadmap to getting his complete commitment. And I've got a very short free presentation on men and commitment and what you need to know. Just go to click the little link you see below the video here. And of course, do the big three for all of my videos. Make sure you subscribe so you keep getting them every week. Make sure you like this video, click the like button below. And of course, leave me your questions and comments. This is Carlos Cavallo from datingadviceguru.com. As always, live and love with passion.